Ja, the question of nationalsozialistischer Hintergrund is, I think, a problem and a question we all have in Germany after, if we were born after 45, and which doesn't end at a special generation, because we still feel, all of us in a way, ashamed and even if not directly responsible, but we have this burden of responsibility and guilt. And there are different ways to deal with it, but it is there. First, it was a question in my youth to our parents and grandparents, of course. And both my parents came from very conservative families, very Prussian conservative, so in a way too conservative to have sympathy with the Nazis, which they, I guess my grandparents found, and grand-grandparents found too vulgar. My mother was obviously much too young to take over to be in the party or anything like that. And my father was, I think, a naive young man who went to war in his youth, or quite young as a young man. I think when they both met after the war, their consequence for them was to be absolutely pacifists and to live a very a life which was not conformistic. That was one of their, I think, credos. And of course, to be absolutely anti-racist. They were also sort of anti-church and anti-religion. So yeah, anti-conformism is possibly a good description. And they didn't like authorities, and they tried to bring the children up in a sense of democracy, and to be very aware of how important democracy is, and that we shouldn't accept anybody's authority towards us. And to be pacifistic, so not to be aggressive. I know that many classmates of mine, for instance, had parents who had other consequences, who were much more authoritarian, and who, for instance, when Germany got the Bundeswehr, so an army back, which made my parents very upset, that many German of this generation liked that thought. They thought that was right. We know that in West Germany, all this Adenauer era was very conservative, and that many Nazis just stayed in power and continued. And we know that many German talked about the Holocaust in the way that they would not have known at all. And I always felt that as a big lie. I remember teachers, history teachers at school, who tried to sort, not really jump over it, but they didn't teach us enough about it. And that was one first step of rebellion, to ask the teachers to teach us properly what had happened. I think in Germany in the later 70s and 80s, and that was for sure a result of the students' revolt and of the 68ers' revolt, that our Erinnerungskultur and our Aufarbeitung has been done in a very thoroughly way. So after some time, so thoroughly that unfortunately nowadays Germans start to be proud of that in a way. They think we are so fantastic how we our Erinnerungskultur is so great that others, all others, should be should take us as an example. And I feel that very often also is rather vulgar to think in this way. And so it is, for instance, forbidden in Germany to, as we recently experienced, if a man who thinks from a point of view of an African country and he dares to bring up the genocides of colonialism and even German colonialism, which is very much denied in Germany still, that he's not allowed to speak and not allowed to say that. And that is, I think, an arrogance of the Germans again, which I see to come up again. The Germans always have the feeling that they are better than others, and I think that is a really a great problem that will always lead to racism and will always lead to to make yourself exclusive and to injusticeness.